Late on Tuesday night, Syrian state TV carries a breaking news announcement. Damascus has agreed to an Arab League proposal to end the eight-month-long uprising. President Bashar al-Assad's government will formally accept the proposal on Wednesday. Until now, there'd been speculation on whether Syria would even accept the plan, proposed at an Arab League meeting in the Qatari capital, Doha.
The meeting was characterized by serious and frank discussions. We reached a proposal that deals with all the issues. The Syrians asked to give their answer tomorrow. But what's more important than the answer is the implementation of any agreement. That is the main point. I can't give you any details on the proposal until we hear from the Syrian government, and they still have to present it to their government.
Among the points in the plan is an immediate end to the violence, which means Syrian troops should be taken off the streets. At the same time, security forces should stop their crackdown on civilians. And thirdly, the government and opposition should immediately convene a national dialogue. The Arab League proposal to end the violence comes as international pressure on Syria grows.
Killing one person is like killing the whole of humanity. But unfortunately, there is an authority which is killing hundreds of people, whom I believe are martyrs. This is an authority based on power, not on the will of the people. It is an authority using the power of the weapon to try and silence the people. The president is like his father, Hafez al-Assad, emulating cruelty against people in Hama, Homs, and Daraa. We cannot remain silent in the face of this process. We are obliged to display the necessary stance, and we will do.
Protesters in Syria were calling for a no-fly zone, but this was ruled out by NATO. Assad also warned that foreign intervention would have repercussions across the region. For now, it looks like international mediation, albeit from the Arab League, is what Damascus is prepared to accept. Charlie Angela, Al Jazeera.